not by might, not by power, but by my spirit. Come on, if you're joining us online, hear this word that was prayed. Not by might, not by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord. And so I want us to cry out right now. There are people that it's not going to be any of our might or our power that's going to bring any change in their lives. It's going to be the Holy Spirit. And we've heard some prayers already lifted up that it doesn't matter if they're here or 600 miles away. Our prayer, our cry can move God to send His Holy Spirit to free people. And so come on, lift up your voice. This is our prayer tonight. This is our cry, not by might, not by power, but tonight, God, by your Holy Spirit. So if you're praying for someone, just pray, oh God, by your Spirit tonight. May it be tonight, God. May it be tonight that you bring that healing. May it be tonight that you bring that breakthrough. May it be tonight that you break the power of the devil in people's lives. May it be tonight, oh God, that you stretch out your hand, oh God, and do what we can't do, God. Hear our cry tonight, Jesus. Come on, there are people tonight that their lives are hanging in the balance, and they need a miracle tonight. They need the Spirit of God to move tonight. So lift up your cry for them right now. Lift up your prayer. Move tonight, Jesus. Stretch out your hand tonight, God. Do what only your Holy Spirit can do. Come on, only your Holy Spirit can remove the veil from people's eyes and remove the blindness from their eyes toward you, Jesus. Only your Spirit can cause their eyes to see. Come on. Only your Spirit can save our daughters and our sons. Come on. Only your Spirit can remove the hardness from their hearts and the veil from their eyes. Only your Holy Spirit can turn their eyes to you, Jesus. Come on, hear our cry tonight, Jesus. There are so many people I'm praying for, God, that it weighs me down. But God, it's not by might, it's not by power. It's by your Spirit, Lord, tonight. Only your Spirit can heal a person's body that needs desperately to be healed. Only your Spirit can raise the dead. Only your Spirit can raise the Lazaruses. So Lord, hear our cry for some raisings tonight. Come on, some healings and raisings and breakthroughs. People that the devil thinks he's got them and he's dragging them to hell. Stop his pursuit. Come on, break his arm tonight. Take back what the enemy has stolen tonight. Rescue people from hell tonight, Jesus. Rescue them from the pit tonight, Jesus. Rescue them from the lies. Rescue them from the darkness, oh God. Come on, shine your light into the darkness tonight. Help people to see the light tonight, Jesus. Hear our cries. Rescue people. Deliver people. Heal people, oh God. Come on, people we've seen no movement in. We say to mountains, be moved tonight. Break chains tonight, Jesus. Come on, captives. Captive is a cliche if you don't know what it feels like to be captive. Come on. It ceases to be a cliche when you know what it feels like. So we cry out for the captives tonight. Come on. I am sick of their captivity. I feel sick tonight. I'm sick of their captivity. I am sickened by their captivity, God. Come on, Jesus. Rescue the captives. I can feel what their captivity feels like, and I'm sickened by it. Oh, God, rescue them from their captivity tonight, Jesus. Their captivity to religion, their captivity to the world's narratives, their captivity to their lusts. Lord, we cry out deliverance tonight. Deliver tonight, Jesus. Come on, pride is a captivity. Deliver people from their pride tonight. Freedom. Freedom tonight. Come on. Freedom. We cry out freedom tonight, Jesus. Freedom tonight, Jesus. Not by might, not by power, but by your Spirit we cry out, Lord. That mountain is an arrogant thing. It's been opposing you, but not any longer. We pray tonight, remove that arrogant mountain, Jesus. Say to that foul mountain, be moved tonight, we pray. Oh, Jesus, come and move in this place, oh God. Move in us tonight, oh God. Come on, church, cast your care on Him. Cast your burden on Him. Give Him your cry tonight. Don't hold it any longer. Don't hold on to any burden any longer. Cast it on the Lord tonight. I'm so burdened for Elizabeth down in Florida, but I can't heal Elizabeth. I can't remove the pain from her brain. God, heal Elizabeth tonight, God. Oh, Lord, heal her from the torment, oh God. So many people that we love are suffering under torment, oh God. And we cry out, Lord, bind the tormentor. Silence the tormentor. Drive the tormentor out tonight in the name of Jesus. Silence his taunts. Silence his lies, oh God. Bind him and we pray. Loose every demonic work of the devil. Be loose tonight in Jesus' name. Free the captives tonight, Jesus. The people that are bleeding tonight, may they touch the hem of your garment, Jesus. May they be healed tonight, Jesus. May they be healed tonight, Jesus. Come on, Lord, heal the mentally ill, Jesus. Heal people's minds tonight, Jesus. Restore people's minds tonight, Jesus. Oh, Jesus, come and move tonight, Jesus. Set your presence down in this place, oh God. Let there be a cry that goes up from this room, Jesus. We're just going to trust you. We love you, Lord. We're going to trust you with our cry. We're going to trust you with our burden tonight, Jesus. We're going to believe tonight, Jesus. Amen, church, that husbands are coming to you and wives are coming to you and children are coming to you. And come on, someone, let's praise Him right now like we believe it's so. We're going to sing in just a minute, but let's praise Him right now. Praise Him for the healings. Praise Him for the deliverance. Praise Him for the breakthroughs. We praise You for the chains that are falling off right now. The blind eyes that are seeing, oh God. The hearts that are changing, oh God, tonight. We bless You, Jesus. We bless You, Jesus. Come on, give Him your shout tonight, church. Give Him your shout tonight. Give Him your shout tonight. the garment of praise tonight. Hallelujah.
Almighty God of love, be welcome in this place.
there's a slide I want you to put back up of this song. Let your word move in power. Let what's dead come alive. I want you to put that up, put that slide up, and I want you just to pray that out wherever you are. Just pray that. Don't just sing it. Let's pray it. Lord, let your word tonight move in power. Come on, pray it over your home. Let your word move in power in our home. Let what's dead come to life in our home. Let your word move in power tonight. Come on, cry it out over your situation. Let your word move in power. Let what's dead come to life tonight. Come on, Jesus, in this neighborhood. On our streets, oh God. Come on, Jesus, put the enemy to flight tonight. Put fear in his heart tonight. Come on, reclaim ground, people. Come on, reclaim the ground. The enemy, you can't have this ground. Let your word move in power in us. Let what's dead come to life tonight. Too much is at stake. Too much is at stake, oh God. Let what's dead come to life tonight, Jesus. I'm reminded of Pastor D with her daughter when she came to that place where she just had an encounter with the Lord, and Pastor D was given that revelation, I will not make peace with my daughter's sin. And there are things we're not going to make peace with. Come on, somebody. We're going to bring war to the enemy. We are not making peace. Paul said that our battle is not against people, but it's against powers and principalities and rulers of this dark world, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Come on, tonight we do war on you, enemy. We do warfare against the enemy tonight. Pull down his strongholds in the name of Jesus, we pray. We will not make peace with people's sin, with rebellion, with darkness, with lostness. We will not make peace with it. We're going to take our stand and pray that your word moves in power. Come on, tonight, may your word move in power in our children. Move in power in our loved ones. Move in power. May your word move in power. And may what's dead come to life tonight, Jesus. And every prodigal on that portrait down there and upstairs, oh God, may your word move in power tonight. May what's dead come to life. Come on. Church, how many know we would not have a building big enough for all the people that... If all the people we know would come to Jesus, there wouldn't be three services room enough, four services. Oh, come on, Lord, let your word move in power. Let what's dead come to life, God. Do it tonight, Jesus. Come on, let's sing it again, Pastor Chad.
Let your word move in power. Let what's dead come to life. Let our shouts be your anthem, your renown, fill the sky. We are here for you. We are here for you. Nothing can stand against the power of our God. You shine in the shadows, you win every battle. Nothing can stand against the power of our God. An almighty fortress, you go before us. Nothing can stand against the power of our God. You shine in the shadows, you win every battle. Nothing can stand against the power of our God.
Bring your glory down. We're gonna keep giving out.
we keep showing up. God, we thank you for your promises tonight. We thank you, Lord God, when two or three are gathered in your name, that you're here in the midst, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for the power in your presence tonight, God. We thank you, Lord, there's healing in your presence tonight. We thank you, Father God, when we're empty or when we're broken or we're dry, God, you come and fill us in your presence. God, we just want to keep being together, Lord, gathering together in your presence so we can keep seeing you work miracles on our behalf, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. We worship you, Lord. We just exalt your name tonight.
Shadow where I you're good, Lord. You're good on a prayer meeting night, and you're good on a Monday morning, Jesus. You're good tomorrow in the frustrating situation that we're tempted to worry about. You're good over that, Jesus. You're good over every situation, oh Lord. Come on, church, help me declare His goodness. Not only over the blessings, but over the hard places. Lord, we declare You are good. Oh, Lord, You're good over everything, oh, Lord. We declare You're good over our past, Lord. You were with us when we didn't realize it. You're good with us now in the fullness of the season we're in, Jesus. You are good in the unknown, Jesus. The things that we don't have figured out, the miracles that we're midway point in, oh, Lord, the slow miracles, the things we're waiting on. You're good, Jesus. We declare Your timing is good, Jesus. We declare Your knowledge is good, Jesus. We declare knowing You is sufficient for every situation that we will ever come through, Jesus. You are so good, oh Lord. You're good for our future, Jesus. We praise You, Lord, that Your goodness supersedes my ability to even comprehend. Hallelujah. We praise You, Jesus.
Mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in Your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God.
All my life you have. Father, I thank you. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you, God, that out of your goodness and in your kindness, you lead us to repentance. Thank you for this precious gift that we have, oh God, that brings us to the freest freedom we could ever know, Jesus. Father, I thank you that in your goodness and in your mercy, you unveiled our eyes to see the depth of our depravity. You've uncovered our hearts, oh Jesus. You've softened them, oh God, to make them tender to your spirit, tender to your voice, oh God. Father, I thank you for the goodness and suffering, oh God, when nothing made sense, oh Jesus. You did not change. God, I thank you, God, in your goodness, oh God. You exposed sin, oh God. You exposed infidelity. You exposed lies. You exposed addiction, oh Jesus. God, I thank you that our mess is not too messy for you. I thank you that our brokenness is not too much, God, that you can't repair, you can't restore, Jesus. You are more than able. Thank you, Father, the generational sin is not bigger than your holiness and your goodness and your righteousness. God, I thank you for the places, Lord, that the things that I see that I don't understand, oh God, but man, does it draw me ever closer to you. I thank you that the confusion, God, it has served the purpose of God making me look for you. Making me cry out to you, Jesus. Although Satan is the author of these things, oh Jesus, I thank you, Lord, that you're bigger. Thank you that your voice is more tender. Thank you that you don't shame me to look for you, oh God, but you gently remind me, oh Lord, that you're there. And so, Father, tonight, I thank you that that's for all of us. I thank you, Jesus, that repentance is for all of us. I thank you that healing is for all of us. There are no orphans in the kingdom. And so, Father, tonight, I thank you that we can all cry out, Abba, Father. And we're no longer slaves to sin. We're no longer slaves to fear, oh Jesus. But we are your children. We are your chosen ones, oh God. So, Father, thank you for your goodness. That has been running after me from forever, God. Thank you for your goodness that is running after my family, oh God. I thank you for your goodness that's running after, Lord God, all of these things that we are lifting up to you, Jesus. Thank you that you are going to accomplish. You are going to accomplish your will. You are going to accomplish what you've set out to do, oh God. It is your desire that any be, Lord God. It is your desire that all be saved, oh Jesus. And I believe, oh Jesus, that you're going to accomplish that very thing, oh God. And so, Father, tonight I thank you that our hope is not in the news. Our hope is not in a president. Our hope is not in policy. Our hope is not in the culture. But our hope is in the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords and the name above all names. In the one who is not like man who would lie. Our hope is in the promise keeper and the way maker and the miracle worker. Our hope is in you, Jesus. Thank you, Father, that we can hope in tonight. Thank you, Father, that we can hope in hard places. Thank you, Jesus, that whenever, Lord God, everything looks dismal and gray and black and dreary, Lord, your goodness shines through every single time. And so, Father, thank you, Jesus. You are faithful. You are good. You are good, Lord, and we love you.
Yeah. Come on, let's just agree with that prayer. Amen. Now listen, lay your hand on a person next to you and just let's close with this agreement. Father, we know tonight, we are convinced that you are here. We're convinced that it's not by might or power, but it's by your Holy Spirit. We believe it's by your Spirit that everything that is happening and gonna happen is by your Spirit. It's not by the arm of flesh, but it's by your Spirit, Lord. And so we can rest tonight. We have cried out to you. I'm praying for all of us. We have cried out to you tonight. We have lifted our voices and brought you our petitions, our desperate needs, the people we love. We have cried out with a full throat. We've poured out our hearts to you, Jesus, for these things that we care about, that we know you care about, the people we love, the situations. And tonight we're going to take heart. We're going to be comforted in knowing that it's going to be by your Spirit. It's not going to be might or power. It's not our efforts. It's not how well we do it or how well we say it. It's going to be you, Jesus. It's going to be you that moves the mountain. And so we just say thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we're reminded in Revelation 7 that we have an accuser that is furious. It says here in Revelation 12, he's furious at us. He's furious at the image of God in us. He comes to make war against us. And he breathes out threats. And I pray this for anyone who feels this, but I believe it's many, maybe even many online, that there's a darkness you're feeling. There's a heaviness, oppression. And it's not you. It's an adversary that is oppressing and taunting and cursing, and it says here he's hurling his threats. He's accusing. Some of you can feel him in your home. You can feel the darkness. It's not you. There's an enemy that is trying to wrap his tentacles around people we love and destroy them. And we can feel it. Even if they're not in the same house, we can feel the darkness. We can feel the enemy trying to win and taunt us in the process with things that we don't see. And so tonight, God, we come in the name of Jesus with this promise that we overcome him by the blood of Jesus. And so together corporately, we just pray, give us greater understanding of how to overcome the devil by your blood. Help us to understand, help us to have revelation to comprehend how to activate the power of your blood against our adversary. We plead your blood against him tonight. We pray that by your blood he would be defeated. Come on, he would be destroyed. He would be demolished. His works would fail. His works would be destroyed in people's lives. His attempt to destroy people we love, that by your blood, we pray. We plead your blood. We plead the blood of Jesus. We come at the enemy with the blood of Jesus, who's trying to destroy nations and pit nations against each other, and a nation, America, to be divided. He's on the pursuit. But help us to not fight in our flesh, but help us to fight on our knees and in our prayer time, that it's through your blood, Jesus. And it's through the word of our testimony. Help us to declare the witness of the truth, to speak the truth of your word, to speak the promises of your word, to open our mouths and declare what will be because of what you've said, Jesus. And he does not know the future. He's not omniscient. He doesn't know like you know. Not even close. And so may we overcome him by the word of our testimony. And so, Lord, may the word that you place in us rise up in us, and may it come out of us to overcome him with the word, to overcome him with the witness, the truth. God, help us to proclaim the truth out of our mouths, the witness out of our mouths that silences the enemy, God, that silences him in our homes, that silences him in the streets, and silences him everywhere we go, God. May the enemy be silenced. In the name of Jesus. Come on, we bind him in Jesus' name. We loose in Jesus' name. Now, Lord, the person we're laying hands on, Lord, fill them with a fresh endowment of power with the Holy Spirit. Just flood them with fresh insight, fresh revelation, fresh love for you, fresh power, fresh anointing, fresh courage, fresh boldness, fresh strength, God. Fire, fire, cleansing fire upon them, Jesus. We pray that your Holy Spirit will rush in and fill them and empower them. And Lord, tonight, break off things as we pray. Break off fear. Break off heaviness. Break off any unbelief. Break off any oppression tonight, Jesus. We come against it in the name of Jesus. And pray the enemy would go now in the name of Jesus, would have to leave. So touch and heal and minister your grace online and right here, Jesus, we pray. In your name, Jesus, we pray. Let's say it in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. Come on, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Come on, let's stand and give him a big praise. Come on. Let's stand to our feet and give him a big praise. Amen. Turn to someone and tell them you love them and you need them. And I'm going to need someone to move my podium. So we're going to pray a little bit more here for Chris and Gina. And so Pastor Michelle's going to bring a little announcement about what they're about to go into, and then we'll pray over that, and we're just in the river.
Amen. Well, little Naomi is having a major heart surgery on Monday, August 26th. And so tonight look at how cute she is. How many of y'all know Naomi? She is a joy. She is so precious. And so tonight, what we're doing for this family, don't we love the Harstons? Gina's gifting and Chris's kindness and his talent, and they're just such a precious family. Tonight, we're taking a love offering to help them out over the next few weeks with her recovery. She will be in the hospital for at least 2 weeks. And so if you feel led, there are traditional tithing methods, so you can give in the box and just mark it special offering, or you can scan the QR code and you can Venmo. We're also going to be setting up what's called a meal train, where you just sign up for either a slot and fix a meal, or you could provide a gift card, you can donate that. There are all kinds of ways to help serve the family. So if that's something that you'd like to help with, you can just reach out to Christy Glick.
Let's have some of our people go and lay hands on Chris right now. And I know he feels the burden, and we can see it on him. And we're just going to lay hands on you, Chris. And I know Gina's back in school, I guess, already. And so, Jesus, let's just pray. God, just touch Chris, touch Gina. Be with this family that we've loved, that we've walked this journey with for many, many years, God. And give them every assurance tonight. Every assurance of your love. Every assurance that you're going to be with them. Every assurance that when they feel like they're not going to have strength enough for the next 2 weeks or however long it is, that you'll give them more than enough strength. You'll give them more than enough grace. That you won't come up short. That you'll supply their needs tonight according to your riches and glory. In fact, you're moving on people's hearts tonight to give. You're moving on our hearts to click that. We're going to put that back up there. Keep it up there. We're going to screenshot it and give how we can give, and people are going to give by being there to help them and provide gift cards and whatever we need, Jesus. You're going to tell us what we need to do, and we'll feel the burden to do it, Jesus, and help them. We pray in every way that you'll touch Naomi, God. Every way. Just heal in every way, God. heal her spirit, soul, and body. Touch her from the top of her head to the bottom of her feet. We pray for doctors to be astounded at what they discover when they go in, Jesus. How much better it is and how much it's beyond their comprehension what you've done. We just ask tonight just a simple prayer, but would you stretch out your hand and heal and perform a miracle? Miracle, sign, and wonder on behalf of your name, Jesus, we pray for Naomi. God, touch Gina. Give her mercy after mercy. Touch Chris, oh God. Pray that in this whole process, they'll be healed. May through this process, may they even experience healing in their life, spirit, soul, and body, Lord. So we lift them to you tonight. We just pray that they would feel your presence all around them. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Amen, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. If you're feeling darkness in your home, if you're feeling any demonic oppression, just know it's not yours. Amen? It's not yours. It doesn't belong to you. It's not your fault that it's there. It's an adversary who violates the law all the time. He's always breaking the law. And we have to remind him that he's not welcome. Amen? Yeah. We have to overcome him with the blood of the Lamb. We have unsaved people that live with us. We have family that are around us. And sometimes we can feel the darkness that they carry and just don't agree with it. I love what Pastor Dee discovered in her journey. I'm not making peace with my kid's sin. I'm going to stand against it. I'm going to fight it. I'm not making peace with it. I mean, I don't love the person, but I'm not going to make peace with it because all I'm doing is sealing their fate. Amen? So Jesus, give us wisdom how to stand in the midst of that, how to identify that darkness and not let it set down on us. Amen? Sunday, I'm going to talk about some things that Jesus is doing right now, and it's just really amazing how God's working in the earth. If you're in the prayer room much, you're hearing a word acceleration. There is an acceleration of God's activity. He's accelerating his activity. And so I think Pastor Ben prayed it. What took years is going to take days. That God just suddenly does things that we're seeing week after week. We're seeing people that we don't know how they get here. And we prayed for a long time, but boom, all of a sudden, you know. And that's something you find in the book of Acts, is that things would be just suddenly. And they would pray constantly, but then God would do things suddenly. I think we get the day with the Lord's 1,000 years part, and he gets the day. I think we get the 1,000 years and he gets the day. So someone that I have prayed for decades, I just found out that has nothing to do with our church. Never been here. But someone I grew up with is about to get baptized. Wow. And this person was way off. Way out there. I mean, you know, like just gone. And now she can't get enough of the word and prayer and Jesus. I remember praying with this. We were at a general assembly up in Indianapolis, and we were sitting in the same section with this family, and I guess something with the conference was about that. And so she turned to me and we prayed for her daughter. And that must have been 15, 20, I don't know how many years ago. It's a was a long time ago. And she just messaged me. And she saw something, the mother saw a post I did about our baptisms and the prodigal portrait. And she said, could you screenshot that? My daughter's name's on there. She said, I want to send it to her. I want her to know how many people from everywhere were praying for her. Because now she's not defensive about it. She's open to it. Listen, if you think someone in your life can't be saved, this girl would be worse. I'm just telling you. Don't come up here with me with your stories. I got a better one, all right? Don't give me your junk about how hard. No, this girl was off the reservation. That's not even politically correct. But since I'm Native American, I can say it. So my wife's going to get me when I get home. I am Native American, that's true. I got a card right here, you can see it. Choctaw. My people. If I just moved to Oklahoma right now, do you understand? I would get free eye care and free dental, and I would have literally free health insurance right now if I would just move to Oklahoma. I just can't do it, though. So I'm going to pay the high premiums. I'm going to pray for my own dental work. And y'all don't know that. It's true. I'm not lying about any of this. But I'm way off of the course of where we were. I'm off the reservation. So if you think that this person in your life is so lost that they can't be found, this person would be way beyond. Like, she moved on the other side of the planet just to get away from her parents. But where can I go that your presence won't find me? Right? And sometimes the ones that don't go, but the ones that stay are harder, because then we got to look at it all the time. And we got to see it. We got to visualize it. We got to deal with it. But I want to say that there's an acceleration. We've been hearing that in the prayer room. There's an acceleration of God's activity, and He's delivering people. He's rescuing them. And so maybe it's because they're feeling the depths of the darkness like they've never felt it before, and it's scaring them back into faith. So that's going to happen before the Antichrist just really rises up and just takes authority and so forth. I believe that can happen. I believe our prayers are doing this. Kirby, last Wednesday in prayer, Kirby prays. She prays powerful prayers, but she came up and she prayed a desperate, broken prayer, like a touch the throne. And I hadn't heard that from her. I hadn't heard that cry in a while, but it was just a desperate cry. And it was for prodigals. She started naming them. And then it flooded over into the prayer meeting last Wednesday, and we had people up on the stage, if you remember, praying out for these needs. And this guy over here named Brett came in. And Brett is, his name's on that prodigal portrait downstairs. And his parents drove down from Carthage, Missouri to be with their son in his crisis. He lives out in east of Dallas in Greenville, and has driven in the last three services. And last Wednesday, so here's the timetable. Last Wednesday, a desperate cry went up, the Wednesday before, from Kirby, and then it filtered into our prayer meeting. The following Wednesday, he shows up. Do you think there's an accident, timing? And so I just want to tell you that when you feel the enemy trying to muffle your cry or to tamp it down, let it go. Like like Hannah, pour out your heart. Just pour it out. Don't let it bottle up, because that can become oppressive to you. Just cry it out. Lift it up. Lift up your voice like we did tonight. And I believe that God's timing of giving us that cry coincides with the work he's doing. And so last Wednesday, God put on Brett's heart to get his parents to drive him over here to this church. It wasn't their idea, it was his idea. And they were here at the prayer conference 7 years ago and put his name on the portrait. And I think Brett was here. You were here at the conference too. And something in his mind came into his mind to come from Greenville here last Wednesday night. And so God's arm is not too short that he can't save. And so here we are having prayer meeting, and here's Brett, and he's already had this encounter with Jesus, and then he hears us talking about baptisms, and so they come back Sunday, and Brett's dad, Bobby, who was a pastor, is a pastor. He got to read his son's baptismal testimony before he got baptized. And here's the beauty of the whole story is all those years ago. See, I knew them from Nashville, Tennessee, when my dad pastored, because they went to our church. In a sense, Bobby and I were in the same church. He was just really a young person. I'm 54. He's 30. Yeah. No, I'm talking about, Brett, I'm sorry. You were just a baby.
I'm 38.
Yeah, so, and my dad dedicated Brett. Yeah, I meant Brett. Yeah, Bobby's older than me for sure. So, because I think you guys were in the youth ministry. You were part of the youth ministry.
We taught you in junior high and Sunday school.
That's right. Little network here. Who can do that but God? Amen. Come on. So Brett got baptized and is on discipleship with some of our people, and I don't know what's next, but his new thing is what's your
now and next.
It's just daily die. Take the next step with Jesus. Take the next step with Jesus. But I would say that if people came to them before this happened a few weeks ago, the parents might say, Brett's really, he's far gone. It'd be a real miracle for him. And we get that, but where's the miracle? So if we think for a second that God is somehow, his arm is shortened, Isaiah 59 says his arm is not too short that he cannot save. His arm's not weakened that he cannot deliver. So that happened.
Amen.
And that's a suddenly. That's an acceleration. And so I was going to do Isaiah or Psalm 84, but it's in the prayer room and you can study it. We're going to go over it. There'll be time for it, but we're going to close now, because we're going to try to keep our prayer meeting to an hour for kids to get home and parents. But Jesus, thank you. Thank you for the acceleration of your power. Thank you that the adversary is the one who is in flight, not your people. We are not to run. We are not to hide. We are not to shrink back. We are not to be afraid. And we will not be afraid. We will stand. We will keep crying out. We will keep believing that there is no one that can get too far gone for you, Jesus, to reach. Psalm 139 reminds us, where can we go that your presence will not find us? Even if a person makes their bed in hell, even there you will find them. You will rescue them in that Sheol, in that dark, dark nether region. And so, Lord, we take heart tonight, Jesus, that no one's beyond your reach, that no one is beyond your grip, that no one is beyond your love and your power. And so, Lord, we just pray, give us grace to keep standing and crying out, lifting up our voices, believing, not agreeing with the darkness, not agreeing with the oppression. And even now, in the name of Jesus, we break agreement with the darkness and the oppression that wants to make it hard for us to believe or pray. May we be reminded, Jesus, that there are breaths out there that are on the brink of a breakthrough. There are Kelly Showalters out there that are on the brink, that are on the brink of a breakthrough, Jesus. And so, Lord, I thank you for Kelly's salvation. I thank you that she's about to get baptized, this precious girl that I grew up with. It was so far away from you, but now she can't get enough of you. And so, Lord, we just pray tonight. Go to people's hearts that we've prayed for. Open their hearts to you. Lift the darkness off of them and hear their cry for salvation. Hear their cry of repentance, Lord, tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. God bless you. We love you. Oh, yeah. Amen. College students, we love you. We'll see you Sunday. Some of them will be gone this week, but we're praying for you. We're standing with you. We love you guys. I know. Seth and Liam, we love them. God bless you guys.